This video is sponsored by Opera. More about them at the end. When I took this photo, I didn't know what I was looking at. It seemed like a rainbow, except with all of its color drained away, like a shadow or a ghost. Ghost rainbows like this are technically called fogbows, and fogbows form in almost the exact same way as regular rainbows, except for one key difference. They only form around Halloween. No, it's actually that the water droplets are around 10 to 100 or more times smaller than those in a rainbow. And that's what makes all the diffraction. I mean, all the difference. So, let's get into how smaller droplets remove the color from a rainbow. There are some great in-depth explanations for rainbows, so we won't get into the details here, but the relevant summary is this. When sunlight strikes a drop of water, some of it reflects backwards off the insides of the drop at a bunch of angles, but most brightly at around 140 degrees. The exact angle depends on the color, with bluer light bending the most and ending up closest to 140 degrees, while redder light bends the least. The result is that white light gets spread out into a rainbow-like spectrum of colors when it reflects off the inside of a raindrop. So if you look up at the sky at a collection of drops, when you look up at an angle of 42 degrees relative to the direction of the sun, you'll see redder light coming from those drops, and when you look at 40 degrees relative to the sun, you'll see bluer light, with the other rainbow colors coming from drops in between. And there you have it, a nice rainbow. Except light is a wave, and waves can interfere with each other and themselves, which messes up the perfect light ray picture we just presented. In the case of the reflected light from a raindrop, the physics is similar to what happens when you shine a light through a slit, since a reflection off of a small object isn't that different than sending light through an opening the size of the object from the opposite direction. With a slit, interference happens because waves passing through different parts of the slit alternately add up or cancel out and create what's called a diffraction pattern of bright and dark spots. And with a small object, it's the reflections off the different parts of the object that add up and cancel out. The effect on rainbows is that instead of a drop just reflecting back bright light at around 140 degrees, there are a bunch more bright reflections at more extreme angles, and this means that each color doesn't just appear as a single ring, but instead a bright outer ring and a progressively fainter series of concentric inner rings. The reason we don't see concentric rainbows is because of a key property of diffraction patterns. A wide slit will have lots of narrow, closely spaced bright spots, while a narrow slit will have wider, farther apart peaks. The narrower the slit, the broader the diffraction pattern, the wider the slit, the tighter the pattern. And the raindrops in normal rainbows are the equivalent of very wide slits. For a rainbow formed from raindrops a millimeter or larger in size, the diffraction pattern is so narrow that the effects of diffraction are essentially absent, and you get the crisp, high-contrast, stereotypical rainbow. But for drops a bit smaller than a millimeter, the diffraction pattern creates concentric rings for each color that are far enough apart to create extra repeating colored arcs on the inside of the original rainbow. These are so-called supernumerary bows. With even smaller water droplets, around a 20th of a millimeter, the rainbow and supernumerary bows get even broader and even farther apart. But crucially, different colors of light are still only bent away from each other by the same amount as before, and so the broadening of the rings causes colors to blur into each other, making the rainbow less vivid. Eventually, with super small water droplets a few hundredths of a millimeter, like you get in fog, diffraction causes all the individual colors to broaden out so much they pretty much completely overlap and add back up to the same original color of sunlight as they started. White light. You can see the same thing happen if you look at red, green, and blue colors through an out-of-focus lens. They blur together into white. A fogbow is still basically a rainbow, caused by the same physics, but it's one that's had the color blurred out of it by diffraction from the tiny fog droplets. P.S. If you take just a single slice from a rainbow and plot how the rainbow changes as the water drop size gets smaller, you get a really cool diagram. On one end, we have slices corresponding to the purest colored rainbows, and on the other end, slices corresponding to pure white fog bows, with all the other varieties of rainbows with supernumerary bows in between. It's a true opera of colors, which brings us to today's sponsor, Opera. When I first saw this phenomenon years ago out on a walk, I was baffled and had to scour the internet to figure out what it was. If instead I could have uploaded the photo to Opera's image recognition tool, I would have immediately seen that it was a fogbow and gotten a quick overview right there, as well as a deep dive via the links provided. Deep diving is also assisted by Opera's tab islands. You can neatly group papers, videos, and searches into separate tab islands, keeping everything organized while still leaving space for your email. And tab traces keep track of where you've been most recently. The darker the underscore, the more recent the visits, you can more easily keep track of the tab you were just on. Plus, Opera's pop-out video player lets you watch videos while you browse, which is great for following along with tutorials or how-to videos. So if you're inquisitive, creative, or love to multitask, then try Opera. You may discover a new essential tool for web browsing. Download it now for free via the link in the description.